Hi, and welcome to this edition of County Talk. I'm your host, Crystal Pruitt. Today I'll be talking with Ed McCrane, Sarasota County Emergency Operations Chief, and Scott Montgomery, Recovery Section Chief, about the 2012 hurricane season and how residents should be prepared if a major storm event threatens the Sun Coast. Then Rob Day will share some important tips on the items everyone should include as part of their hurricane kit. We'll also have a report about the recent Sarasota County Emergency Management hurricane drill and how many agencies are coming together and preparing for this hurricane season to keep us safe. But first, Curt Preisser brings us up to date on some of the important issues, public hearings, ordinances, and other items that came before the Sarasota County Commission recently on the County Board Report. Curt?
Thanks, Crystal. The month of May was a busy one for the county commissioners. It started off with talks about a new emergency operations center. Now, the board voted to have staff proceed with the final design and construction of that new 911 emergency operations center, better known as an EOC, on the county-owned property located near 1301 Cattleman Road here in Sarasota. Now, the board did express some concern with the May 31st deadline for a state grant that will expire on that date and could contribute some funding to the portion of the project.
Somewhere they're going to have to see that we approve construction. And I don't hear that today, and I'm concerned that between now and May 31st.
Now, Public Safety Communications General Manager Bob Stuckey told the board how they intend to address those concerns.
What will be coming forth is a letter for an extension of the grant of 1 year. And within that, we will show the budget and the timeline. It doesn't really necessarily talk about the source of the funding, but it does talk about, you know, the budget and the timeline. So that will be included in our extension.
Following some additional discussion, the board moved to select the Porterway site, which is located behind 1301 Cattleman Road, as the location of the new 911 EOC site, and directed staff to proceed. Staff also informed the board that they anticipated coming back before them to seek approval of funding for the first phase of the project, which is tentatively scheduled to start in mid-2013. Next, the board considered a proposed $350,000 agreement with the Sarasota YMCA for the reimbursement of capital improvement expenses associated with the 2013 Pan American Masters Swimming Competition that will be held at the Selby Aquatic Complex. Now, County Interim Chief Financial Planning Officer Steve Botello explained to the board how the current obligations of TDT funds would prevent them from right now authorizing an immediate allocation from that account.
The piece of the TDT that would be eligible would be a portion of the third penny that's currently allocated to activities, attractions, and promotions. So we've worked with the county attorney's office and verified that this project would be a legal use.
Botello then explained to the board that they did have an option to take the money out of the general fund now and put it back later.
One of the things we were discussing is how could it work, and it would be maybe we would reimburse the project out of the general fund with general revenues. And then if the board voted, I think it's simple majority, to direct this piece of the penny when it's available, we could then pay back the general fund for the expenditures.
The board directed the county administrator and the county attorney to amend the contract to include a loan from the general fund in the amount not to exceed $350,000. That'll be reimbursed by future revenues from the Tourist Development Tax Fund and bring it back to the board for consideration. The Sarasota County Commission is always looking for ways to add jobs in the community. The board approved an Economic Development Financial Incentive Grant request from the EDC, that's the Economic Development Corporation, for up to $124,000 on behalf of a business codenamed Project Pineapple that is looking to add new jobs in Sarasota County. Now, the board has been dealing with a lot of these types of requests over the last couple of years, and Commission Chair Robinson pointed out that staff and board spent quite a bit of time reviewing proposals before making a decision on how to proceed.
That we do analyze and vet these things before they come before us to make sure that we are that it's appropriate, that the incentive is appropriate for what they're asking for. So it's not a given when you ask for something that you're going to get it. It's after staff analyzes it and we get the choice. The board gets the choice as to which way they want to go. So I thought that was important to note.
While the name of the company was not revealed, we do know that the company will be expanding into an existing commercial structure. It's expected to add about 60 jobs over the next 4 years and is expected to have about a $72 million economic impact on the region. It is a presidential election year. The board expressed some concern with the perceived lack of communication, outreach, and education on redistricting by the Supervisor of Elections Office. The changes in the number of precincts in Sarasota County from 156 precincts down to 98 is necessitated by law following the 2010 census. Supervisor of Elections Kathy Dent then told the board that she is bound by law to notify all the voters of the precinct changes.
That the mere fact that our congressional seat number went from 13 to 16 necessitates that I mail a new voter information card to every registered voter in Sarasota County. That alone necessitated the expense of the mailing.
In the end, the board voted 4-1 with Commissioner Mason opposing to approve consolidating and renumbering the voting precincts in Sarasota County. The Supervisor of Elections will hold a series of public meetings to inform the public and take questions from them with regards to the recent redistricting process and the subsequent changes in precinct boundaries and polling locations. Now, if you want to know if your voting location has changed, you can find that information on the Supervisor of Elections website, sarasotavotes.com. And last but definitely not least, public support of the Sarasota County Library System was on display in the board chambers on May 22nd as the commission recognized the library system for winning the coveted Florida Library Association Library of the Year Award.
Now, therefore, we, the Board of County Commissioners of Sarasota County, do hereby officially congratulate each member of the library family for their exemplary dedication and service, resulting in the Sarasota County Libraries receiving the Florida Library Association 2012 Library of the Year Award, presented this 22nd day of May, 2012. Ladies and gentlemen, congratulations to our library system.
Now, if you've never been to a Sarasota County Library, or if it's been a long time since you've stopped by, you don't know what you're missing. So visit one of the 9 locations throughout Sarasota County, or check out their website, which you see right here on the screen. Now, to keep up with all the issues, discussions, and decisions of the Sarasota County Commission, keep tuned to right here on Access Sarasota with live meeting coverage, or after the fact by going to our website at scgov.net, then clicking on Meetings and Agendas, and then Sarasota County Commission Meetings on Demand. There you can review past meetings. You can also follow us on our social media channels at Facebook and Twitter. Until next time, I'm Curt Preisser. Back to you, Crystal.
Thanks for that report, Curt. We're going to take a short break, and when we come back, I'll talk with Sarasota County's Emergency Management Chief, Ed McCrane, and Scott Montgomery, Section Chief, about the 2012 hurricane season and what residents can do to be prepared. We'll be back.